The Arab world, please help me welcome Ali Almasri.
Okay, so today I'll be presenting mainly my typefaces. I'll be talking about some of my typefaces. But before that, I will tell you like how everything started, okay? And the focus will be on the chronological order and how I went from my first typeface to my current typefaces, okay? So, actually, I kind of started in 2005, like almost like 10 years ago. My start was like, I was like just playing around with like computer softwares, and one of them happened to be a font making software called FontFork. And like I created two typefaces and I just wanted to do something with them. So I sent an email to my fonts, okay. And with my fonts, they like replied to me the second day. They were just sending me like a contract to sign. They told me that he was like, "This is to let you know that we received your signed agreement today. I have counted." So okay, so they sent me an agreement, and I was like shocked. Okay, so I signed the agreement that was in 2005 in November. And since then, I was like maybe the youngest designer and maybe the only Arab designer with my fonts from Jordan. The typefaces that I created, I was playing around, so it's nothing serious. Okay, after maybe 2 years, I called them and I told them to like take them off the website. Okay, they were like Latin typefaces. Okay, but. When I played around with these typefaces, I felt like an urge to like this is what I want, because like I have managed to make like some money out of it, and at the same time I'm like passionate about like technicalities of type design and the design itself. Okay, so I got a buzz, and there was like a Jordanian blogger. His name is Ahmed Hamid. He wrote this article about me. And saying Zarqawi font designers, I happen to be from Zarqa, which is the same city that the assistant of Ibn Davin is from. Okay, so in 2006, after I published my typefaces on my fonts, I guess a client from Ireland contacted me, and he was telling me that he wanted a custom Arabic typeface. And I've never done any Arab typeface before, but I didn't. I don't see anyone. Okay, so I told him okay, and I called it Waraq. It was supposed to be like for a game, okay, for the user interface in Amman, and this was my first custom typeface, maybe my first typeface ever, and it was like for something like $1,000. I was so happy to consider it. And then in 2007, I decided that I want to take this like more seriously. And I started reading more about type design. Back then, there was like nothing about type design, especially when it comes to the Arabic. So I had to like start reading and like teaching myself more about the Latin type design. And I started with this typeface. It's called the Tizan. It was like playing around with the balance in the corners, something rounded and something sharp at the same time. Okay, so I started to learn how to create weights and like the proportions of the letters and so on. And it was like contrast, all the technical stuff. And I created 8 weights out of it, and then I created the Arabic companion to it. Okay, and then I decided, no, I don't like it, I don't want to publish it. Okay, I want something more professional, so I kept it on site. Then that was in 2007, I was studying industrial design, and for 3 years, like, I was, okay, I will get back to type design later. 2010, I decided to go back and start with another typeface, which is the Swiss row. back then the trend of matchmaking and taking a Latin typeface and making Arabic on the imprint was very trendy. So I took Swiss the Helvetica typeface, okay, and I created this company. The story for the name is that like Helvetia means Switzerland, okay, in the Latin, and Helvetica means the Swiss type. And at the beginning they wanted to call Helvetica Helvetia, but the Thai founder told them that you cannot call a type face after a country. So I did that. I called it Swiss. Okay, and here's some of the typefaces. And it's also, I created it in 8 weeks, which is, wasn't also like a popular practice in the field. Okay. And that was also 2010. After that, I took Etizan and Vetica and Suisra and showed them to like a professional tag designer in Jordan. And he told me that like, this is shit. This is not tag design, okay? So I was so pissed off and like I went back home and I wanted to create something for like a text typeface. Because he told me that you cannot even call yourself a tag designer unless you design a text, a type that works for text settings. So I went back and I started with Batsam. It's a multilingual typeface. But that was back in 2010 as well. Okay, and I did all the research and the testing for like small sizes, and I showed it to many type designers around the world. Okay, and I got feedback on the Latin, like from students who studied in the Reading and so on. The specialty about the project for Batsam was to coming up with a cursive companion, which until now there's. I don't think that there is like even one typeface that has a cursive companion, not slanted. Okay, so my theory was to work on this Ijaza style, which is like a hybrid combination between the Nasch and the Thuluth. Okay, and what I noticed that the calligraphers back then used to use the Ijaza script for margins or for highlighting like some names, which is the functionality of the italic or the cursive. Okay, so I took it and I redrew it completely. As you can see here, it's like each letter is drawn again, and it has like a bit of a slant and like more ligatures. This is like more linear construction. Okay, and also I added a display companion to it, which is the Thuluth. I was so pissed off. I wanted to be like a professional designer. So I added the text and the cursive and the display, and out of the display I created like two alternatives. Okay, so each letter should be drawn like 8 times, like the text and the cursive and the display as two alternatives, and all of these will be also like cursive as well. Same applies to the other one. Okay. So the plan was to like finish Batsam and publish it, but it took me like so much time. And back then, the technology was like, very, very difficult. There wasn't glyphs. And I decided to that I can't wait like to finish Batsam. So I published Swissra in 2014. Okay. And that was my first typeface, okay? And then I wanted, like, I'm still working, like, it's 2016, almost 17, I'm still working on Batsam from 2010, okay? But I think it would take more time, so I decided to, like, keep on, like, publishing, like, display, headline typefaces until I finish Batsam. So I will show you some of them. This is Mulsaq. The brief of it was to create a typeface that has like a blocky feeling, just like the blocky feeling of a full caps setting, okay? With almost no descenders, no ascenders, as you can see here. The Waw and the Zin and the Ha, almost all of them on the baseline, and also the ascenders. because of GRIFS, I had the luxury to create alternates for each letter, like as you can see here. Also the ligatures, and I created also like I created also alternates for the ligatures and swoosh as well. And here are some of the posters that took the hipster theme. And as you can see, here are the variations for like, all the ligatures, and it's a multilingual typeface. And then in 2015, I took the decision to leave my full-time job, which was a branding agency in Amman Syntax, and I decided that I want to be like a full-time type designer. And at the same time, it was a coincidence, it happened to start with me traveling here to Cairo, and I fell in love and I decided to stay here. That was in like early 2015. And I decided to create like a typeface that is inspired from the Egyptian culture. And one of the most important aspects is that the affiche, the movies that posters that were created for the movie posters. And most of the posters that were created in like the 70s were done in Daruga style, but it has like this kind of special treatment, which is very bold and very, very sharp. Okay, so I took this treatment and created this typeface, which is also, it has the like the sharp and bold treatment to it, and at the same time it's a linear and not very slanted roha. And I decided to call the way it's in the Egyptian slang, which is Msalwa, Adi, and Encompass, and in between our systems. Okay, and now I'm also creating another additional ways, in addition to Msalwa, Encompass, and Adi. One of them will be Gharan, which is this one, this kind of treatment was working on the posters. And there's going to be also the Mugrim, which is very sharp. And Beriz, which is very rounded. And also, I'm planning to launch the typeface in Amman, like in December, with some limited edition posters. I'm also will be working on a workshop for the lettering and the illustration. I'm collaborating with an Egyptian illustrator, and we'll be doing the first edition of this workshop in Kuwait during Nuqat. And here is my business card that I created with like a stamp for the letter from each of my typefaces. You can meet me after the presentation.